Hey guys, it's C-Drama Invasion here, and welcome back to a new video. Today we're already on episode 8 in this new series where I catch up on a bunch of updates and latest news on a couple of actors and actresses, as well as some drama news. If you're new to my channel and you want to see similar content, I'll leave links down to all the types of playlists for videos that you can check out after this one. You can check out the previous episodes and find it in the link below, as well as some of my other series such as Facts and Profiles on popular actors and actresses. I cover their biography, lifestyle, upcoming dramas, as well as personal relationships and hobbies. So make sure to subscribe if you like my content and turn on that notification bell. Give this video a big thumbs up. It really does help me out. And let's just jump on into it since today we have quite a lot to cover. Let's start off by talking about the winners for TC Chandler's Top 100 Faces of Asia this year for 2020. And for this year, let's talk about the top 10s. I'll be talking about the actresses or female celebrities that are in the Chinese entertainment industry. So, Zhao Liying got 6th place, Dilraba landed in 4th place, and Angela Baby was the highest ranking among all of the Chinese celebrities. So she ended up in 3rd place as the most beautiful or top faces of Asia. Although she hasn't been so active in the drama industry, she has been super active and on almost every single variety show or new variety shows there is. So I'm not too surprised. What are your thoughts? And let me know who your picks would be. For the male section, let's talk about the top 15 since there were way more noticeable candidates on the male version. So Lei or Zhang Yixing was 13, Jackson Yi was 11th ranked, Song Wei Long was in 7th place. And as for the top 5 candidates, in 5th place, Wang Yibo won. 3rd place was Sai Shukun, who you might know from Running Man or Youth With You. This has been definitely been his year, and it seems like a lot of the followers are watching Keep Running or Running Man China, since both Angela Baby and Shukun is on that show and they both got 3rd place. I thought that was kind of interesting to point out. And 1st place of all of Asia is Xiao Zhan. Congratulations to these beautiful actors and actresses, and leave a comment on what you think about this down below. And let's move on to the next piece of news. Next up, let's move on and talk about Jin Han. And he is recently confirming his relationship status publicly with actress Zhang Zixi after they were spotted on a date. So Zhang Zixi is known for one of her roles in the drama Love and Destiny. For fans of that drama, she did play Qing Yao, who played a doctor or a senior sister to the main female lead. After being spotted out with the actress, he boldly confirms that they are dating and says, "Don't really have an idol's burden, nothing I'm afraid to admit." And he even tagged her on Weibo, I believe. And then she responds publicly and says, "When I heard you say those words to be with me, that's when I decided to always be together." These two are getting cozy and really close in public, and they're not afraid to show it. After this news was confirmed, these two were spotted on a new date where they were spotted kissing publicly in Shanghai. What are your thoughts on this? Are you shocked? honestly, I'm really happy for them, and it's so nice and refreshing to see actors and actresses that are coming out and admitting that they're dating. People from the industry, I think that just shows how strong they are together and that their relationship is going very steady. I'm happy for them and I hope that they'll stay happy. Anyways, let's move on to another piece of upcoming drama news regarding Jin Han. So he has an upcoming drama with Jo Chen called Hello, My Shining Lover. This has a potential air date in the upcoming months of 2020, but we're not too sure. I know it's been done shooting for a while now and we're just waiting for it to air. But recently they released a couple of new posters, so maybe this is a good sign that this drama might be airing in the near future. So this drama is about two individuals who are aces at their respective fields of work, and these two both bear some emotional scars and trauma from the past. They start a journey of healing together and become the best of themselves together. This is a business hate to love romance drama, and the photos look quite good. I am a fan of Jo Chen, so I might check this out when it does come out eventually. Speaking of upcoming dramas that Jin Han has been working on, his latest drama has wrapped up filming on October 29th, 2020. And this drama will star Peng Xiaoran, who is the female lead. I know so many fans of her from the drama Goodbye My Princess, and I'm glad to tell you that she's been working on quite a few upcoming historical drama projects for 2021 and 2022. There is no English title for this drama at the moment, but I will definitely update you in a future video as we get more news in the upcoming months, so make sure to subscribe. Right now, it is titled Jun Liu Ling. As always, these titles will be in the description box for you to view after the video. This drama is about a princess who finds her father, a former crown prince, murdered. She then sets out to unravel corruption behind the political court and win the hearts of people and try to find out who murdered her father. This seems to be one of those political mystery dramas with a bit of revenge and lots of schemes and politics involved. There also seems to be a love square involved, since in the synopsis I found, she has an involvement with the main male lead, who is a prince, another nobleman, and also her ex-fiance. And let's wrap this up with some heartwarming news. A week ago on October 28th, Tiffany Tang recently posted on her Instagram a photo of her hubby Liu Jin to celebrate their 2-year anniversary after they got married. They are one of my favorite celebrity married couples of all time. And also recently she posted a photo of her daughter's hand, who was watching her latest drama, which has been currently airing, called The Legend of Xiao Chuo, which is a historical drama starring Tiffany Tang and Sean Doe. What are your thoughts on this drama? I really want to know if you've been watching it lately. I've been wanting to watch this for a while now, but I'm just waiting for all of the English subs to come out so I can binge it. And that is it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed this one. Make sure to check out the previous episodes if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Bye.